Let us look at one more programming example in Java. Write a program to accept 10 integers in a single dimensional array. Sort the numbers in ascending order using bubble sort technique. Now you should recall what is a bubble sort technique. I have explained it in one of the previous videos. You can go and watch it if you need to. But still, I will explain it briefly. Let us consider this is a representative diagram of an array. This array contains 10 cells and the index numbers will be from 0 till 9. And these are the numbers that are stored inside the array. When we are doing a bubble sort, we will compare two cells, two adjacent cells. If you want to sort it in an ascending order, then the smaller number will be to the left and bigger number will be to the right. Therefore, if you compare first two cells, 11 is bigger than 8. Therefore, we will interchange 8 and 11. Now in the next iteration, we will compare cell number 1 and 2. And if this number is greater than the next cell, then we will interchange it. So 1 will come here, 11 will go here. So this way, in each iteration, the larger number will be shifted to the right. The largest number will be shifted to the right. And in the next iteration, we will leave this cell apart. We will leave this cell aside and we will only work on the remaining cells. And again, we will shift the larger number towards the right. Now let us see how it is done programmatically. We are going to use the scanner class. As scanner class is part of the utility package, therefore you need to import the utility package first. And then we can create a scanner object. Import java.util.star. This is how we import the utility package. Then we will create a scanner object. Scanner sc is equal to new scanner in bracket system.in. sc is the name of our scanner object. Then we will create an integer array. Int a square brackets equals new int 10. A is the name of our integer array, which will contain 10 elements. Then we will create integer variables to be used in our program. In this case, we are going to use int I, j and temp, three integer variables. Now we can fill the array with numbers. As there are 10 cells, we are going to use the for loop. For I equals to 0, I is less than 10, I double plus. Then we can write a message for the user to enter a number. And then we will write a in bracket I equals sc dot next int. AI is our array. SC is our scanner object. And next int is the method from the scanner class. This statement will accept the number that the user enters and it will store it inside an array cell. The array cell will iterate from 0 till 9. Therefore, each time one cell of the array will be filled with the numbers that the user will enter. This is how we fill the array with numbers or integers. Once it is done, then we can try to sort the array using the bubble sort method. We are going to use two loops. The outer loop will have I, the inner loop will have j. We will use I in the outer loop, we will use j in the inner loop. In the outer loop, we are going to write for I equals to 0, I is less than 9, I double plus. If you recall, while filling in the array, we have used I equals to 0, I is less than 10, I double plus. But while sorting, we are going to use 9 instead of 10. Here in this loop, we have used the integer I, the variable I, which is directly used inside the array. But in this case, the variable I is not being used inside the array. In this case, from I equals to 0 till 9 simply represents the number of times the loop will iterate. So we need to iterate this loop only 9 times from 0 till 8. 0 till 8 will be 9 times. We are going to run this loop 9 times. Let us see why. The inner loop will be for j equals to 0, j is less than 9 minus I. We are going to use a number which is smaller than 1 than the number of cells inside the array. This is the important thing that you need to remember. For I equals to 0, I is less than 9. J is less than 9 minus I, J double plus. Now, we are going to use a comparison operator. We are going to use a if statement. If AJ is greater than AJ plus 1, we are using the variable J for the array. So, initially, J will start with 0. If A0 is greater than A1, this is A0, this is A1. If A0 is greater than A1, yes, in this case, A0 is greater, then we will use the variable temp to interchange the values of these two cells. One will come here, it will go there. Because we are doing ascending sort, we are going to sort it in an ascending order. Therefore, smaller numbers will go to left and bigger number will go to right. So, what will be the last value of AJ to notice here? When I equals to 0, this will become J is less than 9. It means J is 8. At that time, this statement will become if A8 is greater than A9. It means A8 is greater than A9. This is how we can access the last two cells. Only if you use a numbers one number smaller than the size of the array. Therefore, we have used one number smaller. So, what happens in the inner loop? We are going to compare two numbers from the adjacent cells, starting from the cell number 0. If AJ is greater than AJ plus 1, if AJ is greater than AJ plus 1, then we are going to interchange it. Again, in the next loop, we are going to compare these two cells with the updated value and again shift the number if it is bigger to the right. Thus, each time the bigger number will go on shifting to the right side of the array till the biggest number will go to the last cell. After that, in the next iteration, we need to leave this cell. We don't need to do anything with this cell. We'll keep this cell as it is. Therefore, we are using this for loop. J is less than 9 minus I. In the next iteration, I will become 1. So therefore, we will be running this loop from J equals to 0, J is less than 8. It means we are going to leave this cell aside. Again, in the next iteration, we leave this cell aside. So that's how this for loop works. I hope I am able to explain it. So this is how the bubble sort works. When the loop completes, we will get this array in the ascending order. Now this is the most important line of this program. If AJ is greater than AJ plus 1, it means look here. If AJ is bigger or greater than AJ plus 1, then we will shift the things so that we get an array in the ascending order. What if we want to sort it in a descending order? That time, the only thing you need to change in the program is this thing. If AJ is greater than, instead of greater than, if you make it smaller than, then the program will change entirely. Then it will sort in a descending order. You can try to, you can do that practically and see how it works. Now you should try to write this program on your own in the BlueJ compiler and see how it works. So if you want, you can see this program at the bottom of this video pasted as a comment there. You can read the program there and also you can copy it and paste it in the BlueJ compiler. Let us run the program and test it. Class save, compile. Right click on the programs icon, select void main string arguments. Press OK. Enter 10 integers, enter a number. Now we need to enter 10 numbers. Enter in a zigzag way. Don't enter numbers in any specific order so that we can test the program. So as soon as we enter 10 numbers, immediately the program sorts it and displays all the numbers that we have entered in a ascending order. Now, as I already explained that you can also use this program to sort things in a descending order. So all that we need to do is to make a small change in the program. This is the place where we need to change it. If aj is greater than aj plus 1, so instead of greater than, if I make it smaller, let us see what happens. If just I make a small change to, instead of greater sign, I will change it to a smaller one. Class save, compile. Before closing the terminal window, you always make a habit to clear it. Otherwise, the output remains when you run the next program. Now let us test this program again. Now I will enter values. Now as you can see, the program has successfully sorted the numbers in a descending order. So I hope this is helpful for you.